welcome back to my channel. I'm ASMR Puns. Today, I'm going to be going through some of my favorite graphic novels and illustrated books for you. They will be in alphabetical order, and I have about 6 or 7 of them for you. So, before I get started, I just wanted to mention to you again to subscribe to this channel and click the bell icon to receive notifications from this channel when something new happens. And also, be sure to give a like to this video, a thumbs up. So, without further ado, the first book that we have in alphabetical order is actually a number. Also struggles with his sexuality and caring for his aging aunt, who's the only family he has left, only family member he has left. It's a very nice book. I just saw it at the comic book store one day and thought, check this one out, it looks pretty interesting from the cover. And it was a very good book. So, what are you? If you're addicted to drinking, but also can't stop coughing and crying. What are you? If you're addicted to drinking, and also can't stop coughing and crying. You're an alcoholic. The Alcoholic by Jonathan Ames. The Alcoholic was also illustrated by Dean Asbiel. Next one. This one, again, one of my personal favorites, and I bet a lot of people's favorites too. And you might have seen this book influencing a lot of films of this nature just based on its style and its content. And that is Batman: The Dark Knight Returns by Frank Miller. This one is illustrated by Lynn Varley, who also did 300, and Klaus Janson. I've always maintained that Batman: The Dark Knight Returns, and this isn't confirmed or unconfirmed, but I always thought that it was an inspiration of Tim Burton's when he made his Batmans very dark, grim. You can also see some of the themes in The Dark Knight Returns in The Dark Knight Rises, the Christopher Nolan film of the Batman trilogy. And also Batman versus Superman: Dawn of Justice as well. This book, the Joker, gets really, really, really nasty. And that nastiness and evilness is also carried along. In other Batman graphic novels. This is also a very interesting story in the Batman universe because it features a female Robin named Carrie. So, very cool book. Batman: The Dark Knight Rises. I have a lot of Frank Miller. Also a fantastically illustrated book, very awesome concept for Frank Miller, and that is Ronin. It's a really trippy book, very trippy indeed. It's about the consciousness of a Ronin, and if you don't know what a Ronin is a samurai without a master. So they're sort of like rogue samurai, but they don't have a master. And fierceness of a Ronin. It gets transported into the future somehow. And puts itself into the body of somebody in the future. In this futuristic dystopian robot controlled, AI controlled world. And the Ronin in this new body has to sort of fix things and try to save everything. Very trippy book. But also very, very, very well written. And again, one of my favorites. Next one is a little bit newer, actually a lot of bit newer, and you might be familiar with it. I just received this in the mail a couple of weeks ago, and I love it. And that is the second book from Nathan W. Pyle, Stranger Planet. I really love how Nathan just... his observations on everyday life and how people interact with each other are told through the first discovery of them by these creatures. It's just hilarious, and it just makes you think about yourself and your family and friends and just the quirky things that people do. I remember in the first book, Strange Planet, there was one comic where two of the beings were trying to put together a cabinet, I'm guessing from an IKEA or a store like that, and it's getting increasingly more difficult for them to cooperate with each other, and then a third creature comes into the room and says, "What are you two building?" And one of them says, "Tension," which is true because I think have experienced trying to put together something with someone and getting angry with them. I know I have. Everybody wants to do things their way. It's just a cabinet. One thing too that I thought was really sweet was I gave my daughter of the first book, Strange Planet, for her birthday, because I was reading this, the first book, with her, and she thought they were funny, funny comic strips, so I got her a copy of the first book, and I also got her a Strange Planet plush doll of one of the creatures, and she thought that was really cool, so you can get all that stuff just by checking out Nathan W. Pyle, Strange Planet, on Instagram. Yes, when you see it. And that is Fever Vandella by Alan Moore. Very great book. The movie is also fantastic. Alan Moore doesn't really care for when people make movies out of his graphic novels. But I felt that the movie for Fever Vendetta was actually almost like half spot on. There were some creative changes in the story. But really good movies still. The book is a lot different than the movie though, but they managed to catch pretty much the same kind of themes and elements from the book in the movie. The movie was done by the Wachowski sisters, who also did the Matrix trilogy. And Watchmen is also illustrated by David Lloyd. And also Fever Vendetta is illustrated by David Lloyd. So, did you hear about that story about a masked vigilante or someone called terrorist who was fighting against an oppressive regime that was keeping cheese from everybody? Cheese. Nobody can have any cheese. It was called Fever Velveeta. And so, for those of you who don't know, if you see this, the movie, or the people that wear this mask in the various protest movements across North America and around the world, this is a mask of Guy Fawkes. Planned to blow up Parliament because England was very restrictive and persecuting Catholics. And so Guy Fawkes, being a Catholic, got together with two or three of his accomplices on the 5th of November and tried to blow up Parliament, but he was caught before he could do it, and he was hanged. And in England, every November 5th, they have parties, and they burn effigies of Watchmen, I was like, how are they going to do that? But he pulled it off. I think Zack Snyder did a fantastic job with Watchmen. He changed the ending a bit, though, but what he changed the ending to in the movie, I thought was very fitting and fit very well. And it didn't screw around with the story. But Watchmen, if you don't know, is all about a bill being passed that basically banned masked superheroes and vigilantes. And the only ones that could practice their profession were ones that worked with the government. So, for example, the character of Night Owl, who's also named Dan Triberg, or Walter Koufax, who plays the character Rorschach. And jobs. Whereas Dr. Manhattan or the comedian work for the government. And it all starts at the beginning when someone throws a much older Edward Blake or the comedian out a window. Probably one of my favorite graphic novels of all time is widely considered as one of the best 100 books of all time. Not just graphic novels, but books. Great movie. Great soundtracks too for the movie. Zack Snyder was able to use the songs that are referenced in this book. So like The Sounds of Silence, You're My Thrill, Bobby McGee, All Along the Watchtower, very good soundtracks. And also a very good score soundtrack as well, again by Tyler Bates. I don't think I mentioned it before, but Zack Snyder also did the movie for 300. Here for Halloween, I went as the comedian. I worked really hard on my costume, and I guess this was like pre-popularity of cosplay, but I thought I did a pretty good job. I'll show you a picture of it right here. Pretty dorky, eh? But that was back in 2007. So thank you for joining me once again on my channel. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, a like down below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And also click the bell notification button so that you don't miss any new updates on my channel. You can also find me on Instagram and TikTok at ASMR Bun. ones. And you can also download my rock and roll audiobook for only $1. It is all about the risks and sacrifices that someone might have to take in order to even have a shot at a career in music. It features interviews with the singers from Finger 11, Monster Truck,